Hi everyone. Today in this video, let us discuss mesalamine. What is this drug mesalamine? This is one of the 5 amino salicylic acid with a simple structure like this. And here we can observe 5 amino group which is attached to the salicylic acid. Simply, mesalamine is a 5 amino salicylic acid. And within the name, we can find where the amine group is attached. With respect to carboxylic acid, this amine group is attached at meta position. That's why we have the prefix ME within the mesalamine. So it is a meta substituted salicylic acid amine. Simply, it's a mesalamine or 5 amino salicylic acid. This drug is also known with another name, mesalazine. Here the suffix may be either mine or gine, both indicates 5 amino salicylic acid. Since salicylic acid derivatives are acting like anti-inflammatory agents such as aspirin, aspirin is the acetyl salicylic acid. So just like aspirin, 5 amino salicylic acid can also act as anti-inflammatory agent. We have one of the drug sulfasalazine, which is a prodrug for 5 amino salicylic acid. So within the body, sulfasalazine is converted to 5 amino salicylic acid by metabolism. So just like sulfasalazine, mesalamine is also used as anti-inflammatory agent. So this drug can be used in the conditions of ulcerative colitis. This is a condition where inflammation is observed within the colon, particularly at the rectal region, resulting in the various gastrointestinal symptoms. And particularly this ulcerative colitis may be increased with any bacterial infection. Otherwise, it can also be produced by stimulation of immune system. Whatever may be the reason, this ulcerative colitis produces various symptoms such as abdominal pain, blood in the stools, rectal pain, unexpected weight loss. All these symptoms can be observed in ulcerative colitis because of increased inflammation within the colon. This drug is available as a delayed release capsule, where each capsule contains 4 tablets of this medication. And this capsule should not be broken, it should not be crushed, and it should not be chewed. It should be swallowed completely. But in those patients who are unable to swallow, this capsule can be opened and each tablet can be then swallowed to preserve the coating on the each tablet and to produce delayed release of the medication. Now let us see the chemical nature of this drug. So this is the simple structure of mesalamine already we have seen. Let us give the numbering. We have to start the numbering from the carboxylic acid. So this is 1, then the preference is given to the OH group. So this is 2, 3, 4, 5. So amine group is attached at the 5th position and the main ring is the salicylic acid, which can be written as 2-hydroxybenzoic acid. To this 2-hydroxybenzoic acid or simply salicylic acid, amine group is attached at the 5th position. So 5 amino. So 5 amino salicylic acid is nothing but mesalamine. Now let us see how this drug acts. Even the exact mechanism of mesalamine is not clear, but it acts topically to reduce the inflammatory response. Within the colon, particularly at the rectal region, increased growth of any bacteria or allergens, they increase the permeability of rectal membrane, and they are going to stimulate the synthesis of prostaglandins. These prostaglandins can increase the mucus production, which protects the colon, but at the same time, they can also produce some inflammation. And they can also stimulate the leukocytes. These leukocytes can be migrated into the membrane as well as the prostaglandins. This increases the inflammation within the colon. Now, mesalamine is one of the drug which can inhibit the synthesis of prostaglandins as well as it can inhibit the migration of leukocytes. By all of these, it can reduce the inflammation within the colon. Arachidonic acid is one of the important mediator which is going to be converted into various prostanoids like prostaglandins and thromboxanes, and this step is mediated by COX enzyme, and selectively COX-1 enzyme is involved at the inflammatory cells. These prostanoids can enter into the cell where they can induce the inflammation. Now mesalamine, just like aspirin, it can block the activity of COX-1 enzyme so that it can inhibit the synthesis of prostaglandins. Similarly, NFKB, nuclear factor kappa B, is one of the inflammatory pathway. It can act on the NFKB receptors expressed on the inflammatory cells. When these receptors are activated by NFKB, inflammation is more pronounced resulting in increased risk of ulcerative colitis. Again, in such condition, mesalamine can inhibit this pathway. Mesalamine can activate AMPK phosphate, the phosphorylated form of AMP-dependent protein kinase. This AMPK phosphate can inhibit the activity of NFKB, thereby it can reduce the inflammatory response. In this way, mesalamine can inhibit the synthesis of prostaglandins as well as leukocytes, as well as it can also reduce the activation of NFKB pathway. By all of these actions, it can reduce the inflammatory response. Now let us see the precautions of this drug. One of the important precautions of mesalamine is that this drug can produce some renal failure in the patients. So this renal impairment may produce nephropathy, interstitial nephritis, and finally it can lead to renal failure. So in the patients with any history of renal impairment, this mesalamine should be carefully given. And sometimes drugs like NSAIDs can also produce the renal impairment. So these drugs should be carefully used with mesalamine. And another important precaution is that many of the nephrotic drugs such as aminoglycosides, amphotericin B, which is an antifungal agent, cephalosporins and penicillins, vancomycin, which is an antibiotic, cisplatin, which is an anti-cancer agent, all these drugs can produce nephrotoxicity. So these drugs should be carefully given along with mesalamine because this further increases the renal impairment. And the important precaution is that mesalamine can induce acute intolerance syndrome. So this syndrome results in few of the symptoms which resemble the symptoms of ulcerative colitis. So mesalamine can produce abdominal cramps, abdominal pain, bloody diarrhea, and it can also produce fever, headache, and skin rashes can be produced. If these symptoms are developed after use of mesalamine, care should be taken to check any intolerance of this drug in the particular patient. And the precaution is that mesalamine can produce some hepatic failure in the patients. So in the patients with any history of hepatic damage, this mesalamine should be carefully given. Azathioprine is one of the immunosuppressants which shows some drug interaction with mesalamine. This azathioprine can be converted into its active metabolite 6-mercaptopurine. So both of these drugs can interact with the mesalamine. When this azathioprine is combined with mesalamine, they can produce some blood disorders resulting in anemia and neutropenia, and caution should be taken while co-administration of these drugs. Now let us see the side effects of this drug. The important side effects are gastrointestinal side effects. So mesalamine results in eructation resulting in belching, abdominal pain, dizziness, sinusitis. It can also produce some back pain and constipation. Sometimes it can also produce bloody diarrhea because of intolerance produced by this drug. How it is given? This drug is available as a capsule, delayed release capsule, and it is available at a strength of 400 mg. For the treatment of mild to moderate ulcerative colitis, this drug is given as 2 400 mg capsules 3 times daily. So for each time, 800 mg of the drug is going to be administered in the form of 2 capsules, and it is given 3 times daily. The treatment should be continued up to 6 weeks in order to control the inflammatory response. And this drug can also be used for management of remission of ulcerative colitis. In such case, the dose is given 1600 mg per day, given as divided doses. So that's all about this drug, mesalamine. Hope you have enjoyed this video. If you like this video, please subscribe to our channel, share this video with your friends, post your comments in the comment box. Thank you for watching this video.